We're here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit and the Singapore Grand Prix is just about to start. The name Singapore means City of Lions, and this weekend, Formula One will be roaring into action. The bumpy street surfaces here make this a challenging circuit for the drivers, and the humidity causes them to lose as much as 3 kilos over the course of a race. But it's also tough on the cars, with 23 corners to tackle each and every lap. Good low-speed downforce will make all the difference here. This is it. We're down to the last few races of the season, and it's time for that final push. Who will be crowned champion at the end of it all? We'll find out soon enough. The competition is on.
Yeah, all good.
Thank you.
So there was a crash.
Copy.
We've just had a crash on the track. Let's see what happened there. Let's have a look here. This was the Aston Martin.
Carlos, can you hear me?
Yep, all good.
Green light. And radio check, Carlos, can you hear me?
Yeah, can you hear me?
in a crash. We can take a look now. Now let's look at this. Here's George Russell. Dear me. Continues to build here as race day begins.
These past few days, Ferrari have been absolutely thrilling their fans. Now let's see if they can make the Tifosi proud by capitalizing on that grid position. This weekend, Red Bull displayed promise during qualifying. Now they need to capitalize on their grid position and get a good race under their belts. The weather is very overcast here, and teams are staring at the sky, watching for the first sign of rain. Strategies might have to be quite flexible going into today's race.
Well, we've got some fascinating strategies that are sure to be applied today. But for now, all eyes shift to the starting line of the Singapore Grand Prix. It's lights out, and away we go!
DRS enable.
There's been a crash. Sounds like a single car. Let's take a closer look. Now let's look. We're watching Nicholas Latifi.
Hamilton in the barrier.
Copy.
Oh, and that's a crash! Let's have a look. Now, just watch the Mercedes here. They've lost control, and there's the crash.
Thank you. And box now, box.
Copy box.
Oh, did someone run wide there?
And it will be DRS off.
Sounds like there's been a crash.
Yeah.
safety car in this lap, and we'll be in this lap.
Yep.
And boost.
Yeah, copy.
And we'll be turn button off.
Copy.
And turn button off.
Yeah, good.
No lift off needed, you're doing a good job.
Copy.
So there was a crash.
Okay.
We've had a crash. Let's take a look at the replay. Now watch this. Here's the moment involving Albon. A definite collision there. That's very unfortunate.
We are the fastest car on track.
I think that was a crash. Let's see what happened there. Now let's watch this. The Alfa Romeo involved in this one. That crash is terrible news.
Just a reminder on the rest. We just had a crash on the track. Here's the replay. Let's take another look. There we have Joe. Oh, a nasty.
Take the car in this lap.
Yep.
And head on.
Yep.
Really good lap time. And DRS is disabled, DRS disabled.
Copy.
DRS is enabled, DRS is enabled. Free to go.
last lap.
Copy.
And checkered flag.
Let's go, come on!
That's Leclerc. Charles Leclerc is today's winner. Let's take a closer look. Look at that, Leclerc takes first place.
I don't think anyone could be disappointed with a race like that. A consummate professional through and through.
Well, this was definitely Charles Leclerc's weekend. This is a tremendous podium result. It's joy all around for the team. The Monégasque driver certainly proved his worth with a terrific drive today. For these drivers, they'll be taking home their trophies and a decent haul of points for their team. I don't think Ferrari will be too disappointed with that result.
You can see that the team runs like a well-oiled machine. Everything was precise and on point this weekend.
After an intense weekend, the team ends in first place in the constructor standings.
Next round, we'll see us head east as F1 prepares for the Japanese Grand Prix. We'll see you at Suzuka, a firm favorite for the drivers.